Captain America Civil War above. It's going top B. It's topping B.
Oh, so you don't like this one much.
I don't love it. I like it. I just don't love it.
Because everyone thinks First Avenger is the weak movie in the Iron Man trilogy. Do I think this one is?
Yeah, same.
I might put it A, above Guardians.
Actually, I'm going to move Ant-Man to be above Thor. Civil War did have a lot of really good stuff. It handled Tony and Steve's falling out really well.
Also, I really like it in terms of Captain America's story, which is why it belongs in that trilogy and it's not an Avengers movie. Because before Winter Soldier, in fact, that would actually probably be around the first Avengers movie, that would be on opposite sides. Like, Tony and Steve would swap around if this had happened during the Avengers movie. Like, Winter Soldier is what causes Steve to stop trusting the government.
And another thing I do love about Civil War is both Tony and Steve have really good arguments. Neither one of them is, like, clearly in the right or wrong.
Yeah.
Also, Spider-Man's in this. I love Spider-Man. You're gonna see this later on. I really like Spider-Man. Doctor Strange.
The pedophile.
I think Iron Man 2 is going to come down to C tier, and this is going to move up to bottom B tier.
So Age of Ultron's going down to C. Guardians is going down to B. So is Civil War.
Actually, no, I'm moving Doctor Strange up to be above Thor, below Ant-Man.
Doctor Strange is going to C. It's not because I hate him, it's just because we need to start using the middle tiers.
Doctor Strange, for me, it's a movie... I feel weirdly about Doctor Strange, because I enjoy it, but I also don't enjoy it at the exact same time, and I don't understand how I feel about it.
It's too disconnected from the MCU, if I'm allowed to even say that. Like, I feel like some movies... I feel like if there weren't any Doctor Strangers, I'd be like, there's not enough movies that aren't connected as much. Though it does have that little mention of Rhodey.
Steven is a character. I mean, he's okay. I'm not as invested as him into him as I am with a lot of other characters. This movie, it does well to not fall into the fold with just being another MCU movie, even though it is kind of just another MCU movie.
One of my issues in the MCU is that magic is something everyone can use. Because some of these movies, it's starting to really take away from the first Iron Man.
Yeah. Being
when no one believes any of this stuff, especially like when Thor arrives.
Yeah. The universe does get very crowded as time goes on, which obviously it's going to. That's kind of an inevitability.
Which is pointed out in Iron Man 2. They're like, oh, ever since you started doing stuff, we've started to get a lot more of these threats.
Guardians Volume 2. I think Guardians 2 for me, it's definitely A tier. I think it's going to go below Iron Man and above Captain America the First Avenger.
I'm going to chuck it bottom B.
It's a very light movie. It's easy to digest. You can just pick it up and watch it in an afternoon. And, you know, it doesn't feel like a big thing to watch. It feels very digestible. I think it really depends whether you like that kind of thing or not. It's obviously very lighthearted, but it still has those deep character moments. It actually has a really good villain, I think, in my opinion. I like Ego. It does well to, like, be comedic, but also have a lot of really serious shit going on. Yondu's great as well. I just love the characters. The characters are all really lovely. The jokes are really funny. Homecoming. Homecoming is an A tier, without a doubt. Yeah, it's going to top A tier. Guilty pleasure movie. There's a lot wrong with it, but it's tonally perfect. It's exactly the tone that I really enjoy. It's lighthearted, but still takes itself seriously. A lot of people have a lot of issues with MCU Peter. I still really enjoy him. Vulture is one of the most relatable villains, I think. Even Tony in this movie I thought was really nice.
Yeah, I've only thought about my, like, placement of Homecoming within the other Spider-Man movies. Let me think. Actually, I'm going to put it right below Civil War. I think it was a really fun movie. It's probably the only Spider-Man movie that's actually a high school movie. The only problem with Tom Holland's Peter Parker is the only person I really see as Peter Parker is Tobey Maguire.
Okay, Thor Ragnarok.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Bottom F tier, baby. Thor Ragnarok, more like Ball Ragnarok.
More like Ball Ragnarok.
Am I right? In seriousness, top S tier, my favorite MCU movie.
I was going to go top S. The more I think about it, it's a bottom S. Just think Winter Soldier is a better movie. Mostly because Ragnarok has flaws. The main one really being is them cutting away from fight scenes right before they get good.
Yeah, but I think Thor Ragnarok is honestly one of the funniest movies I've ever seen. And most memorable as well. It is a very memorable movie.
Very quotable.
And it's this kind of harkens back to what I said earlier as well, where it's that perfect tone where it's lighthearted, but takes itself seriously enough for me to take it seriously.
Taika Waititi is just the boss at that.
Seeing Thor and Loki in this movie is just a really good kind of conclusion for them, for those two. Hulk is really fun to see. Hulk and Thor have a really nice dynamic. Bruce and Thor even have a really nice dynamic. I will say, though, I'm not a big fan of Hela. Hela was probably the only forgettable thing about this movie.
Also, I hate Hulk's voice.
You're Banner's friend.
Yeah, Hulk's voice is weird. I don't know what they were going for, whether it was intentional or what. Also, the soundtrack was really nice for this one.
Get the lead out.
Don't tell me you guys have never gotten the lead out.
Black Panther. I'm about to make some people mad, but I don't like this movie. Like, at all. I really don't like this movie. I think it's going to top C tier. It's like, it's not terrible, but it's just... It's like one of the first, really, MCU movies. It just feels like an MCU movie. Which is ironic considering it does actually have a lot of really unique identity. I don't find it fun to watch. It's not unfun to watch. The CG is kind of terrible. It's a very meh movie for me. It's a very meh movie. Infinity War.
It's either below or it's right around the first Avengers movie.
I kind of want to put it S tier, but then S tier is just going to get really bloated because I have at least two other S tiers lined up in my brain hole. But it is kind of an S tier. I really like this movie. It's great. No movie I think will ever be able to match like the hype I had going into this movie. Like, this was 10 years of build-up, all culminating into this, and it just executed it all so perfectly. Even though it has so many characters and so many different, from so many different kind of types of movies, it still manages to recapture every single one of them. Thanos is the best MCU villain. Thor was really awesome in this movie. Captain America was really awesome in this movie. Iron Man was really awesome in this movie. It's just an awesome movie, okay? It's amazing.
It's a bottom A. There's not much for me to say, really. Below Avengers, because I think Loki's still a better villain.
Ant-Man and the Wasp, which is definitely below the first Ant-Man movie. It's going to top C tier. It's very enjoyable, but not very good.
Oh, I don't know. I'm the only person on the planet that thinks this, and I don't know why, but I prefer this movie over the first Ant-Man.
Again, it's a guilty pleasure movie. Never know what to do with a guilty pleasure movie, because I feel like I enjoy it a lot more than a lot of the movies that are higher than it on this list, but it's not as good of a movie.
I just think every character is better.
I think it doesn't kind of get that tone as good as Ant-Man does. Like, the stakes don't feel as real.
Maybe that's why I like it.
Actually, not. I'm going to put it right next to the first Ant-Man movie. I'm going to pull it up. It's going to go right below it, but it's going to go next to it. So it's a B-tier.
I convinced someone.
Okay, Captain Marvel. See, I don't want to be one of those people that just dogpiles on this movie, because I don't actually think it's as bad as a lot of people say. But it's probably... I'm going to put it right below Black Panther. In C tier. I'm also going to move Incredible Hulk down to D tier.
Have not seen it.
Okay, I'll talk for the both of us. Nick Fury was cool. It was kind of funny seeing Nick Fury in this, but he's cool. Carol, I actually enjoy her character a lot more than a lot of people do. Some people think she's kind of Mary Sue-ish, which I can see where they're coming from, especially in the end where she unlocks God mode and can just pretty much one-tap anybody by just breathing in their direction. So long as in the future, they make sure that they establish that she does have limits, she can be beaten by people. It's not really a funny movie. It's lighthearted, but isn't funny. It's enjoyable enough to watch. It has a really good twist at the end. Like, one of the best twists in all of the MCU, I will say. Endgame. Endgame is another one of my S tiers. I really enjoy Endgame. I'm just going to put it next to Infinity War because I can't pick one above the other. I love both of them a lot. Same thing with Infinity War. 10 years of build-up. Perfect payoff. Every character is amazing. Tony's send-off was awesome. All the original kind of cast character arcs really come to a nice, satisfying end. Ant-Man was really nice in this. He meshed really well with the original Avengers cast. My only complaint with this movie is that there was no callback scene, and the original Avengers never stood in a circle, which they should have.
It's a top B for me. Not as good as Infinity War. Yeah, I just don't like it as much as Infinity War. It's just not as good. I mean, I love Fat Thor. I love Paul Rudd. I love Professor Hulk. You can fight me on that one. It shouldn't have been permanent. That's where I think people hate it.
I don't mind it being permanent because, mind you, this is like 10 years after the Hulk was first introduced. We had a lot of time to see Hulk as normal Hulk. So if they're going to keep his character moving forward, they need to evolve him. They need to make him different. They need to become, you know, he needs to change. But what kind of confuses me is the thought, like, did Bruce just kill Hulk? Because it's very established that Hulk is an ulterior personality. Like a whole nother personality. And Bruce just killed him. Does anyone else think that way, or is that just me? I don't know.
So in terms of Hulk, I'm going to fight you a bit on this one. In Ragnarok, was the first time we started getting some character development of the Hulk. And pretty much ASAP, we just lose the Hulk.
Another thing, they did a really good job at using time travel, but not breaking the universe. It's very easy for time travel just to make everything way cheaper and seem way less meaningful, but they did a really good way at integrating it in such a way that everything still feels impactful. God, Far From Home. I'm going to put Far From Home top A tier because S tier is too full. It's a really good movie. I really enjoyed it. I love Spider-Man. I love all the Spider-Man characters. Mysterio was an amazing villain. This is an amazing follow-up and epilogue to Avengers Endgame, whilst also setting up the universe moving forward. I just enjoyed, like, Peter and MJ was really nice to see. I actually quite enjoyed those two.
Now, on my Spider-Man tier list, this is the lowest movie. By the way, Venom's not on those movies. Maybe above Amazing Spider-Man 2. Though the touch on you saying like Peter and MJ. Peter and Gwen's so much better. But in terms of MCU, there are some much lower movies. I'm not decided on those two. Mm. Mostly because Movie Flame did a video saying it's the best Spider-Man movie ever.
He's wrong.
Which was before No Way Home.
Mm.
But he's still wrong.
He's still wrong.
I don't know. That really made me sad that Movie Flame would have an opinion that's different to mine.
Makes me really sad that he's so wrong. Like, all his credibility is just out the window now.
Movie Flame, if you disagree with us, do a video with us. Because we hate you and we want to own you on our channel, not because we want to do a video with you.
Yeah, you know, we hate you. You're not like one of our favorite YouTubers. Hell no.
No. But I think it's going to top C tier. Although, I guess there is, like, Edith just being given as Peter. Not so much that he gave it to a kid, because I see why he would give it to Peter. More so when, because he thought Peter was gone until right before he died. And also, just here's something to add on, just in general about Tony Stark. There needs to be there should have been a fourth Iron Man movie. Because from Iron Man 3, like, every time we see Tony, he's got better and better technology.
Mm.
It's like, I want to see him actually get some of that technology.
WandaVision is at least A tier. I actually really like WandaVision. It may be bottom A tier. I don't think I could rewatch it. I could never rewatch WandaVision. But the first time watching it, it was a really fun show to watch. It had a very disappointing final episode, but that's just kind of a common theme with a lot of Disney Plus shows.
Yeah, like Mando Season 2 finale, that was such a disappointing finale.
It does a good job at capstoning what happened in Endgame while also moving forward at the same time.
This is my issue when we, because I really want to do a Harry Potter books and movies tier list. It's the same thing here, like trying to compare different mediums is just pain. Like, it's not an S tier because it's not up there with Captain America and the Winter Soldier. Actually, I'm going to put it right below Iron Man. Oh, yeah, I really like this, the whole sitcoms. And the mystery is so well done. That finale could bring it down, but I'm willing to look past it because it's got sitcom episodes.
Falcon and the Winter Soldier. Doesn't hurt me to move this one a lot lower than WandaVision. I might even put it top C tier. This is one of those shows where there's a lot I really like about it. I really like Sam, like the characters of Sam and Bucky. Zemo is really awesome. Sam's character arc where like learning to be like, okay, I want to be Captain America. And the, whatever his name is, the fake Captain America. He was also really cool. One thing I really don't like about this show is how obvious it was What's-A-Face was the power broker. That was so obvious. Yeah, I wasn't a big fan of Sharon in this. Also, Sam's Captain America suit is really awesome. But we got to see jack shit of it. Especially having come out like straight after WandaVision. Comparing those two shows is kind of what pulls this one down as well.
Zemo was so much better than in Civil War. I liked what they did to him.
Loki. This is kind of a spoiler, but it's probably going to be my final S tier, but it is an S tier. I love Loki. This is an amazing show. Easily my favorite.
You're going to hate me for it, but hear me out. Bottom F tier. Because Owen Wilson doesn't say wow.
Wow.
So I reckon right below Vision, to be honest. Mm.
We'll say one thing I really don't like about this movie is Loki being in love with himself is so wrong on so many levels.
It somehow works, but it's also wrong. The actors have really good chemistry.
Actually, another complaint, I do have another big problem with this show, is that this feels like Loki if he was pulled out of the end of Thor Ragnarok, not if he was pulled out of Avengers.
Yeah. But he watched the movie.
Just killed Phil Coulson.
Yeah, but he watched a video, so he's pretty much a good guy now.
I think this show is a really good setup for what the MCU is moving into. Also, I think this is the only show that was given a 6-episode limit and did really well with those 6 episodes. A lot of the 6-episode length shows feels like they're really limited and pulled down by those 6 episodes. But Loki did really well with it. Black Widow. Guess what? This might be an F tier. No real redeeming qualities. Honestly, I just don't like it.
It's going deep for me. I've already got my Fs filled up. But I do like the character development. What Black Widow gets. And Yelena's so cool.
I think I only like Yelena because of Hawkeye though.
Yeah, that is true. What if we moved on to another show?
Ah, I see what you're doing there, Patrick. This is one of those shows... I have absolutely no idea where to put this. This is very much like what you said with comparing two completely different things, but to the extreme.
Yes.
This is very different to the rest of the MCU. It's going to go right there. Mid-B. Below Ant-Man and the Wasp, above Doctor Strange.
Oh, I don't know where to put it, but I'm guessing I'm just going to copy you and go B.
I really enjoyed it. It kind of had some moments where it was a bit cheesy, and it felt a bit like, especially dialogue was very clunky. Kind of felt very cartoonish.
I did like having, Mark Ruffalo do the Hulk voice around the Edward Norton era.
This is one of those shows that I really hope gets a second season, because I feel like I could just digest a lot more of this before I get sick of it. It's just fun. That's the best way to describe What If for me. It's just a very fun show. I really like how they like linked all of them into the finale. That was really well done. Shang-Chi. Hello, D tier. Got a top D tier. Very much just another MCU movie. It doesn't do a lot to excite me. I'm not very invested into any of the characters. Trevor was really awesome in this, though. I found Trevor to be really fun. That's a really random point and doesn't really contribute to the quality of the movie, but I really like that they brought him back. Not much I can say about it because I just don't feel anything about it. That's why it's D tier, because I just don't feel anything for it. Eternals. Hello, bottom F tier. Eternals, it's just a bad movie. Everything about it. The cast isn't very fun. There's maybe one or two cast members that are kind of fun to watch, but it's got like 12 main characters or something like that. It's got a ridiculous amount of main characters. This is kind of the point where I feel like the MCU is getting too crowded. This is kind of the tipping point for me where it's too much, especially with it being revealed that the Earth is just an egg. Hawkeye. I really like this show. This is a good show. Right next to WandaVision, but just below. Kate Bishop's really a great character. Clint has, I'm guessing this is his send-off. This is a really nice way to pass the torch and send off to Clint. Yelena is awesome in this.
I was going to do top B, though I might move it up because I did enjoy this a lot.
This is a solid show. This is another one that did really well with the 6-episode format.
Now let's talk about like Disney Plus shows and like doing the fake out thing. Kenobi being Reva's show, Loki being Sylvie's show, WandaVision being Vision Wanda's show.
Hawkeye was one of the cases where I was completely aware of that going into it. I don't know if this was common knowledge, but I just assumed it was going to be Kate Bishop's show, not Clint's show.
I mean, it still works because technically Kate Bishop is Hawkeye. However, at this point in Clint's life, it works that it's Kate Bishop's show. We can't really have Clint go through something, apart from, I guess, covering up Ronan. Do I really want a Clint movie or show taking place early?
It's too late. I think it's too late.
Also, I really like that old man wasn't the killer.
I think I'm surprised in retrospect how much I liked it, because as it was coming out, I felt like it was a very mediocre show, but after watching it, I kind of reflecting on it, it was really good, very solid. Spider-Man No Way Home?
Yeah, this is another bottom F tier movie. I just don't know who these other Spider-Men are. Like, why task Tobey Maguire? Like, he's a good actor, but is he really a Spider-Man? Same with Andrew Garfield.
For me, it's kind of a similar sort of situation, but second top S tier for me. You know, very similar. I don't like it very much, hence why it's not first S tier. But, you know, I like Spider-Man okay.
This is a good Spider-Man movie. Is it a good MCU movie, though?
I don't care. It's going in S tier. There is no movie where I've ever seen in theaters that just has a moment that I will never forget. Like, it's just a memorable moment as much as No Way Home. And that's the moment when Andrew Garfield showed up and my friend next to me that I was watching it with got up and yelled, F yeah, but he didn't say F, and there was lots of kids in the cinema. Yeah, no, it was Tobey Maguire, sorry.
Actually, you know what? Now's the time Iron Man gets promoted to S. No Way Home's the top A.
I don't even have any specifics I can say because I will just be listing off everything about this movie. It's a no-notes movie. Looks like I'm guessing this is actually going to be the final time we see Tom Holland's Spider-Man looking at the MCU Phase 5 lineup. I'm guessing we're not going to be seeing him again. This is a pretty solid conclusion.
It feels like a Spider-Man 3. It's a Spider-Man 3 or, you know, Clone Wars Season 5. It's a good spot to close, but it's not full. The book's still a little open.
I do wish that they would continue with it because I think there is a lot more they can do with it. But I'm guessing they're not, and I'm okay with that.
Negatives. Just the setup. It's the whole idea of Doctor Strange casting a spell and then hearing, you know, Peter be like, oh, can we change it? And he's like, and doesn't just stop and discuss it fully.
Moon Knight.
Hippopotamus.
Moon Knight is going to top B. Moon Knight, this is really great. Oscar Isaac really killed it in the role. He really surprised me. The plot's really fun. It was a good show. It does kind of betray the source material and the original fans of the character, which does bum me out a bit. But I loved it. Steven was awesome. Mark was awesome. The dynamic between the two was awesome. And really convincing somehow. It had some really deep psychological shit going on, which was really impactful to see in a Marvel show. Six episodes, again, this one just somehow worked well with six episodes, even if the last episode sucked. Not as good as Hawkeye and WandaVision, but still a really solid show. Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness.
That's a couple.
Okay, actually, you know, I'm going to put literally right above the first Doctor Strange. That's where it's going to go.
I was looking forward to it because of Sam Raimi. Actually, you know what? I'm going to put it better than above Falcon and the Winter Soldier.
I mean, it was kind of a letdown, but for different reasons. There was a lot that I was expecting going into this movie. Like, I thought this was going to be the next big thing. Like, this was going to pave the way for the next lot of MCU movies, but it ended up being very inconsequential, which brought down my enjoyment of it a lot. A lot more than I should have let it, but it still did. Doctor Strange himself in this movie was nice to see. It doesn't feel like he grows much, to be honest. I'm kind of happy that he and the love interest. I'm happy that he and the love interest didn't end up together, just because it feels like they're not following the trope. And also, I wasn't really that invested in those two to begin with. Wanda was probably one of the better parts of this. I really liked Wanda in this. Her death scene at the end felt really underwhelming. You know, like, Wanda's been such a huge part of this universe for so long, and then she's just gone, just like that.
I mean, I know you mentioned Earth 616, which I do agree with, sucks.
Just to explain to the viewers, I hate the fact that they named the MCU Earth as 616 in this movie, because it kind of establishes that the comics and this aren't the same multiverse, which it could just be the numbering system is different. It just feels, you know, it doesn't feel like they're trying to make them fit together, which
kind of defeats the purpose of a multiverse. Yeah, Ms. Marvel, I've seen half an episode and I'm happy to put it bottom F.
I'm not going to bottom F it. I am, however, going to bottom D it. It's not a terrible show by any means. It gets a lot better as it goes on. The first episode, I very much disliked. By the end of it, it warmed up to me a little bit. But the problem is, I am not the target audience. This show was not made for me. I can respect that. If you love it, if it's targeted towards you, good for you. But I don't feel like it's made for me, and that's okay. Love and Thunder, I know exactly what to do with this one. It is going to... I don't know exactly what to do with this one. It's either bottoming A or topping B.
Yes, you're on Love and Thunder, like me. I remember we were on edge when we first watched it, but I'm like, no, it's not as good. We can't quote it.
The first time I watched it, like, I really loved it. I found it was really funny. It was... Yeah, it was just a really fun movie to watch. I have since rewatched it, and I actually got bored. I just didn't find any of the jokes to be funny. My big problem with this movie is this is where I was saying how earlier, like Thor Ragnarok, it's that tonally perfect point where it takes itself seriously while being funny and lighthearted. Thor Love and Thunder is way too much in the other direction. I could not take this movie seriously. From the moment that Thor, in the opening sequence, rode Stormbreaker like a magic broom, I knew I was not going to be able to take this movie seriously. This movie did a really good job at making me believe Thor and Jane's relationship, even though the last two movies did a terrible job at it. It's a good movie, but it could have been a lot better.
First Avengers and Infinity War annoying me. It's going right in between.
This is a really dumb complaint I have about this movie, but this has been bugging me ever since I watched this movie, and this is just really stupid. In Avengers Endgame, there is a scene where Captain America, in the final battle sequence, where Captain America is using Stormbreaker and Thor is using Mjolnir, and he turns around and he says, no, you have the little one, and takes Stormbreaker off of Steve and gives him Mjolnir. But in this movie, he wants Mjolnir and not Stormbreaker. It is an inconsistency, and it bugs me on so many levels so much more than it should. That's my little rant for the day.
I've taken it as a kind of thing of, over time, Thor's realized he misses Mjolnir.
I wouldn't mind Thor wanting Mjolnir over Stormbreaker if that one scene didn't happen. Okay, let's wrap this up because we're both really tired. She-Hulk.
Second bottom.
I'm sorry. I feel like this show has its fans.
I don't think it
but
does.
But it's gonna... It's second bottoming F tier. Eternals is still worse. But She-Hulk, I'm just not enjoying. It's a comedy, which isn't funny. I'm not engaged in the character. The plot is just not very engaging. Just kind of because it's more going for a more episodic sort of format than a lot of the other shows, which are like an overarching arc. I feel like She-Hulk is just the same, where I don't know who it's made for, but it's not made for me. Another dumb complaint I have about this show, which is very similar to my Love and Thunder Mjolnir versus Stormbreaker issue, is that for some reason Jen's hair changes every time she transforms. It goes from being like frizzy and curly to being straight, to being straight back to being frizzy and curly. Bruce's hair never did that. His hair always looked exactly like it did when he was Bruce. She-Hulk is a show where I'm very scared to complain about because I don't want people to accuse me of being misogynistic.
Everyone hates it though.
But yeah, so that's done. We're done. We've been going for like 2 hours. Here it is. It's done. If you have any disagreements, make sure to let us know in the comments down below so that we can roast you for being wrong.
Yeah, that goes to you, Movie Flame. Again, we don't like Movie Flame. We're not just trying to do a video with him so we can video with our favorite YouTuber.